PhD in Animal Behavior from the University of California. She won the John Burroughs Award for Nature Writing and has been published in Nature, Journal of Mammalogy, the African Journal of Ecology, and International Wildlife Convention. She was particularly interested in observing animal instinctual behavior and comparing it to human instinctual behavior. She noted that male baboons would strut in front of women, female baboons, in order to get their attention. And she says, not unlike the male species. And I think we can look at Chase, very attractive and well-built young man, who went to the beach with the girls. And that's where Kaya first met him, as he was strutting his stuff. Females of the animal world care for the young, and the interaction among these herds showed her female connections. It is this information that encouraged Delia to write about an individual who had survival skills but lacked human contact, and the effect of this on the individual. So developed the idea of Kaya and her life of abandonment and handling of that situation. Even her name, Kaya, is related to the animal world. Seagulls make a sound, which she says, the author, very much like Kaya, Kaya. And that's where the name came from. Now, we can look at the story and three category. First is coming of age. By the age of 10, she is abandoned by all her family. Ma was the first, followed by her siblings and then her pop. She is determined to survive. Her survival skills are her experience in the marsh, watching animals interact and forage food. The author, and I found this interesting, chose a temperate climate because she felt that that would make her survival more believable. And you can talk about that later. She is befriended, Kaya, by Jumpin' Jack and Mabel, who own Marsh Gas and General Store. Kaya would barter seafood for gasoline for her boat and food supplies. Often, Mabel would have secondhand clothes from the church. Kaya is also befriended by Tate, a young, very attractive man who was a friend of her brother. Tate represents the finer things of life, poetry, and teaches her to read, and eventually will present her books on the marsh to ecologists. They are published, and she's able to improve her circumstances by rebuilding basically the shack she was left. Tate abandons her. They were supposed to meet on the 4th of July. He doesn't show up. He leaves to do a summer internship that will enhance his career and thus allow him to stay in the marsh with Kaya. But she feels abandoned. And she then meets Chase, who she had seen on the beach with a group of his friends. They develop a sexual relationship, and she truly believes they will marry. While shopping in town, she saw the announcement of Chase's engagement to a local girl, abandoned again. She is offered the opportunity to discuss one of her books at a conference, but this involves her taking a bus, sleeping in a motel, taking the bus back, something she does not cotton to, but she does it. While at the conference, Chase's body is found at the bottom of a lighthouse. Kaya, because people knew of their relationship, is accused of the murder. Of course, the defense claims, how could she have precipitated this, considering her shyness and isolation? Prosecution does not. not have enough evidence to convict. Yeah, they do manage to get some men who say, yeah, well, we saw this boat being driven by a person that particular night, but we really can't definitely say it was her. So she is found innocent and goes on with her life living with Tate. They do not have children, and a new relationship with her brother and his family. She dies at about the age of 60, I believe, and while going through her belongings, Tate finds Chase's missing necklace and a letter in which she admits to seeing Chase that night at the lighthouse. Tate decides to keep the information to himself. We are not certain to the circumstances of his death. Was it an accident or intentional? As the lighthouse symbolizes the firefly, did she lure him there for sex or for death? That's up to you. Now, my question to you is, there's lots of questions, but we could start with this one. How did you experience the book? Were you engaged immediately, or did it take you a while to get into it? How did you feel reading it? Amused, sad, disturbed, confused, or even